Where's your temperature holding?
It's like about 170.
170? Mm-hmm. All right, it's not too bad. Not for this sled. That's overheated in this one. So, you keeping up okay? You're not having any concerns about staying on the trail or?
Nope. If it gets a little dicey, it just kind of let out the throttle and just kind of.
You always have to control, because if it's darting a little bit, you don't want it to dart on you when you can't control it, right?
Right.
But when there's nobody coming, there's no reason you can't relax a little bit, you know what I mean? And push it towards a little bit of the center of the trail.
That's what I was doing.
Yeah, did you see me doing it?
Yeah.
If I can see, I'll relax a little bit. If I can't see, man, you gotta get right over. But you can also see that once you get to be a good rider, how a trail like that could be a real fucking hoot, right?
Yeah.
You know, you'd be fucking like a motorcycle. So that's the whole goal, is to get that good where that doesn't bother you. Now, I don't know how this one's handling. I'm probably gonna switch with you for a minute.
Okay, yeah, it slides around a little bit, but it's like predictable and it's
well,
not scary.
They're gonna, because the trail's been groomed. You can see it's nice and smooth, mm-hmm. but other people have ridden it.
Yeah.
Your sled's gonna wanna grab their tracks.
Yeah, it was grabbing a little bit.
Right, but it's gonna do a little bit, mm-hmm. but I need to make sure, I'm gonna ride it to see how bad it's doing it, okay?
Okay.
Now, I also have studs in that sled. I don't even really hardly notice the ice, okay?
Okay.
But this one might do it, this one might be worse. Just ride around here for a little bit up the road. We're only a few miles from the cabin if you want to ride by there.
Yeah, we'll go by the cabin.
So
what are these for?
What's that?
What are these for?
That will create. That one's running kind of hot right now because the ice is, there's not a lot of snow on the trail.
Ah.
So the cooling system isn't getting all the snow it brushed up into the tunnel. You'll never even know they're there except the temperature will go down.
When we keep them down?
Yep. They're called ice scratchers.
At first I felt like kickstands, like why? The sled just sits right up.
What was that?
I was like, are those stands? I was like, there couldn't be stands because the sled's always like sitting up.
No, that's like I said, those are just scratchers. They create an ice dust that gets drawn into the back of the track, and then the track circulates it on the cooling system underneath the seat. This one, the cooling system's on the foot rails, so it's nice and close to the ground.
Right.
That, it's a four stroke, it runs a lot hotter.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't seem to get so, it's not so critical. All right? Thank you. I keep missing it. I want to take the road. That rides fine. It don't ride like that though, does it?
What's weird is I'm used to like a lower seating position.
Eyes are stinging. Anyway, it's much smoother. It steers easier. It's just easier on my back. But that ride's fine. I mean, that's how they ride. Mm-hmm. Back in 2005, that's what a good sled was. You know, 15 years later, this is what an average sled is.
Right.
You can lower your seating position a lot, I guess. I like it nice and high because I'm kind of big. But, no, they're different rides. But you can see how you could ride a lot longer on this one.
Oh, yeah.
It's not even set to soft. If I set it to soft, you'd get all nice and cushy. Mm-hmm. But that one needs studs. If we still have it next year, we'll put studs in it. That can feel it slipping around on the ice a little bit. Mm-hmm. You don't feel that on this. You notice that?
Yeah,
the back end doesn't wiggle. Anyway, I'm going to punch in a route. To my Dieters.
Right on.
Here. I'll tell you what though, that sled's no slouch for power. She'll rip right out of a hole. If you get a chance to give it a little bit of goose. I want you to have fun, but at the same time, we can't be going faster than you can control, be comfortable with. You have to be ready for anything, you know?
I'm not gonna lie, on that straight, I was hitting it pretty hard.
Were you?
On the straight.
You're taking off? Yeah, because you can't hit it hard on the straight, you just go too fast, and that's dangerous. But when you're taking off, you can get a little shoot. As long as you got plenty of room in front of you, don't run into me. You know what I mean?
Right.
You can see when I slow down, I'm trying to tell you to slow down, where we're going to turn. And if I'm going to pull over, I'll pull over to the side, right? But give you plenty of room to go around me. It just pushes in there, under the button.
Oh, under the button.
God damn, that thing sounds good. running a little warmer than usual. I'm trying to figure out why. Oftentimes ice can build up and I can lower the sled. That'll probably help. You're not having any problems? If that's 50, what does your speedometer say?
So funny thing is, when I go near 60, it'll go like, it'll say 14, 15, 16.
Really?
Yeah, so it'll fluctuate.
The sensor's gotta be acting up.
Yeah.
But we were doing about 50. Did it say about 50 when it worked?
Yeah, it'll go up to the 50s, but as soon as it hits 60, it'll just go into the teens.
Huh.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good job getting up that hill.
Yeah, it was actually pretty easy.
You always gotta remember, you gotta counterbalance it. And then keep it moving. Keep it with that throttle, keep it moving, right?
Uh-huh. Is there a way to remove this padding right here?
Yeah, it just pulls out.
Because it's like pushing against my nose.
I know. It did the same thing with me when I wore it once.
It's just a pain in the ass. Hey.
You're more likely to get a draft. Anyway, this is usually so full, it's just white. Mm-hmm. The only thing that sticks off the trees. That's how little snow we have this year. Usually all this brush is covered with
that much snow.
Mm. Bad year. Anyway, you should hear this thing from behind. You started a little while ago, gave it a couple braps. Sound like a monster. Yamaha sound good.
It feels good.
Pardon?
It feels good.
It rides a little too rough for me, but you're not having any problems at 55, 50, 50. We're doing like 50.
Yeah,
40 to 50.
I feel just fine.
Yeah, okay.
In fact, I feel more comfortable on this than I do that.
Because it sits slower.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of. Take a quick look at that speedometer. It's a pretty simple device.
Yeah, because it's a little wonky.
It's just a sensor down there. I can't get at it from here.
I'll be fine.
Hey, Heather. I mean, I'm kind of wondering why all these sensors are going bad. That speedometer should be acting up either. I mean, the fuel gauge. Never had a problem with fuel gauge. Now all of a sudden I do. You know, I don't know if I remember hooking up the taillight on this thing. Fire it up real quick. It's a brake. Yep, I must have done it. Alright. Daddy gonna pee.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
That's why I brought us out here in the middle of nowhere. I know it's in there somewhere. Make sure you don't piss on yourself. This is more what it's like at the beginning of the year, not the end of the year. All right, well, we're not far from Lupton. Hopefully Mod Dieter's is open. Hey, look at this. You'd hate life if you couldn't see. Yeah, it's fucking snowing. Yeah, I lowered the sled and the temperature dropped. You digging it?
Oh yeah.
It's fun just kind of riding through the woods with nobody. I mean, if you're doing 25, that's fucking drag.
Yeah, I'd say 50 is like when it gets fun.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it's actually quite a bit fun, but 50 is about as fast as you're going to go and be still kind of be safe. But as soon as you get to the trees and the ice, and the, because there's almost always ice in the corners, got to slow down. What you really want, though, is just to do what you want. You know, if you want to go faster, go faster. You want to go slower, go slower. Just do whatever is safe for you. That's where the fun comes in, is the freedom. Man, listen to that thing. That thing's badass sounding. You ought to hear it later.